गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू कंटिन्यू द चैप्टर 8. फर्स्ट आई विल एक्सप्लेन यू द मिड पॉइंट थ्योरम. तो द मिड पॉइंट थ्योरम, द स्टेटमेंट ऑफ द मिड पॉइंट थ्योरम इज, मिड पॉइंट थ्योरम, यू कैन सी दैट इन थ्योरम 8.9 इन योर टेक्स्ट बुक. The line segment joining the midpoints of two sides of triangle is parallel to the third side, right? That means, suppose ABC is a triangle, and E and F are the midpoint of the side AB and AC respectively. We have to prove that EF is parallel to BC as well as EF is half of the BC, right? So E and F are the midpoints of sides AB and AC respectively of triangle ABC. To prove that EF is parallel to BC and EF equal to half of BC, there is a construction needed. Produced EF to D. Okay? Produced EF to D such that EF equals to FD and CD joint, CDU joint. The students, let's proof start from triangle AEF and triangle CDF. We get from these two triangle what we get. See, this angle is equal to this angle. Can we say? No, because we don't know whether this line is parallel or not. So this we cannot say, but we can say these two angles are equal. The reason is vertically opposite angle. So AF equal to CF we can say. So let us say first AF equal to CF. It is AF is the midpoint and EF equal to FD. This is by construction. And angle AFE is equal to angle DFC, vertically opposite angle, right? So therefore triangle AEF is congruent to triangle CDF by SAS rule. Okay, two side and one angle, so SAS rule. Therefore you can say that angle EAF equal to angle DCF by CPCT. And since these two angles are alternate angle, right? These two angles are, since these angles are alternate angle, therefore we can say that AE is parallel to CD, or AB is nothing but same line, so you can say AB is parallel to CD, right? Now also you can say AE is equal to CD. This is also by CPCT. Now from quadrilateral BCDE we get BE is parallel to CD, right? Now see, since AE equal to CD, so we can say BE is also equal to CD, because AE and BE are same, because E is the midpoint of AB. So AE equal to BE. So in CPCT we have got AE equal to CD, so we can write BE equal to CD also. So here we can write BE is equal to CD. So we have got BE is parallel to CD. The reason is AB is parallel to CD and BE is equal to CD, right? You can give equation number 1 from 1. So we know that in a quadrilateral, if one pair of opposite sides are equal and parallel, then it is a parallelogram. So therefore we can say that BCDE is a parallelogram. And we know that in a parallelogram, opposite sides are parallel. Therefore, DE is parallel to BC, or EF is parallel to BC, because DE and EF, it's the same straight line. So we have got EF is parallel to BC. Now the next part, we have to prove that EF is half of BC. So that see, and also we have got that DE equal to BC, ED equal to BC, and ED is nothing but twice EF equal to BC, because twice EF equal to ED, because E is the midpoint of, you can see that AF is the midpoint of ED, so you can write twice EF equal to ED. Now since ED equal to BC we have got, because it's a parallelogram, so you can write twice EF equal to BC. So from here we can say, therefore EF equal to half of BC. Hence we have proved that the line joining midpoint of two sides of triangle is parallel to third side and half of the third side. So using this theorem, let us solve one question from exercise 8.2. The first question is, ABCD is a quadrilateral. Let us draw the quadrilateral AB CD. It's a quadrilateral. A, B, C, D is a quadrilateral in which PQRS are the midpoints of the side AB. PQRS are the midpoints of the side AB, BC, CD, and DA. AC is diagonal. AC is diagonal. Okay, let's join this. AC is diagonal. Show that, number one, to prove that SR is parallel to AC and SR equal to half of AC. So let us prove this one. See, SR comes under this triangle ADC. So in triangle ADC, SNR are midpoints of sides AD and AD and CD. Hence, then SR will be parallel to SC and SR will be half of AC by the theorem, by midpoint theorem, Number two, we have to prove that PQ equal to SR. Okay, prove that PQ equal to SR. Now, we have SR equal to half of AC from one in triangle ABC. We have in ABC P and Q are the midpoints of sides AB and BC. Therefore, PQ is parallel to AC and PQ equal to half of AC by midpoint theorem. So students, you can see that SR we have got half of AC, and here PQ we have got half of AC. So this you can give equation number 2. This is equation number 1. Hence from 1 and 2. We get PQ equal to SR. Number 3, we have to prove that PQRS is a parallelogram. PQRS is a parallelogram. So proof, in PQRS we get PQ is equal to RS from, you can give is 3, from 3, and PQ is parallel to RS as PQ is parallel to AC and RS is also parallel to AC. So students, we know that if in a parallelogram, if one pair of opposite sides is equal and parallel, then the quadrilateral is a parallelogram. Hence, proved. The students, I am ending my video lecture today. Here I have discussed about the midpoint theorem and one questions from 8.2. In the next class, I will discuss more questions from this exercise. All of you, please go through this video and try to understand the concept. And if there is any doubt, you can ask me question. Thank you.